Jesus fucking Christ. Where do I start with this shit? How about what me and my family decided, I think back in April, they decided, son, you have no right to choose what you want to do this summer. And we're going to on a bunch of vacations. One to New Orleans, and one to Jamaica. Better get your accent on. So, of course, because we were going to leave the country, we needed some passports. And passports come into play a little while later, and I'll tell you guys that actually the passports are the most important part of the story. Me being a teenage boy, there's only one thing that I can spend my time doing. And if you're a dude, you know what I'm talking about. Beating your meat to bad bitches on the internet. That is the most important thing in life. To men who are single. And me at the time, I was single. Hold the phone. We ain't gonna have this copyright mess going on. We ain't gonna have this. We ain't gonna have it. We ain't gonna have it. We ain't gonna have it. Well, yeah, we're not gonna have that happening. We ain't gonna have it. So, of course, my mom and dad being as genius as they are, this is when we actually decided to go and get our passports yesterday. Of course, my mom and dad being the kids as they are, they've got their phone. And again, that comes into play. We're going to change the Walgreens, right? And for some reason, Walgreens take passport programs. Any customers that decide that they may want them. You can crash into those things all you want on GTA 5, but when you want to now, you can't do it? Okay. Did I ever claim this car part right here? I have not claimed this free car part. I can always just remove the song. They decide that, you know, we'll take your passport photos. It just so happens that they don't have their camera. And while looking around for it, just the person who, you know, came back without their camera said, "Oh, let me call my store manager." That's it. He probably knows where the camera is. I'm so sorry. My mom and dad, they didn't have the patience for that, so they just got to put down. We were taking these photos at like 5 o'clock. And we had to get to the postal office to get our passports made, right? Yo, tell me why my mom comes up with a genius idea for them to use my phone. And of course, me being me, I decided, I couldn't come up with an excuse fast enough. So they just take my phone and take the picture. Me being the type of dude that I am, I'm like watching the chick working my phone, taking pictures, make sure she doesn't actually look in my gallery. Because if she does, chances are she's gonna see a lot of things that she may find horrible. And then after she takes all the pictures, she holds on to my phone. Oh. She tries to pick my phone up to the computer. And me being scared, I decided to save my phone. I say, oh wait. You see that thing right there? That thing only works for iPhone, so I can't use my phone on that. And if the Walgreens employee wasn't there, it probably would've worked. But then she pulls the part that you plug into like an iPhone or an iPad. She pulls the top half of that off and reveals a Samsung phone port. Then I said, "Why is it taking so long?" I said, "I probably have like 2,000 photos on there." Actually, no, I think I said 1,000. And it turned out to be around 2,000 pic. No, not 2,000. 3,000 and like 469. 3,469 photos. If you can hear, and the worst part is, my mom turns around and looks at me while at like 3,200 pictures. So it just says, "It better not be no naked girl now." And lo and behold, after the download gets finished, chick presses see the last 50 pictures, and about 10 of them, they get bad pictures. Oh my god damn this is what they do to me. This is what they do. Post my gallery in the group. When I see you again, this is what they do to me though. They post gallery images in like, they post my gallery images up on this computer in Walgreens. I thought my parents loved me. But apparently I was wrong, that's because they didn't love me nowhere near enough. That's where like they both didn't look at well, my mom just looked at me and said the Walgreens employee just turned and looked at me and gave me like this smile. That's like and the best reaction to this whole thing has to be my dad, where he turns to look at me and he puts his hand up to give me a high five. And my mom looks at both of us with this look of shame in her eyes, as where she like... And I'm just staring at my dad like, is he about to like slap the fuck out me in this fucking Walgreens? Dad, like, I'm not even going in front. I kinda deserve this. And the fact is, he was smiling through this whole encounter. It reminds me of like that one scene from Friday where Debo, whatever that one dude name is that Debo stole the watch from, or the bike. It was like that whole scene where Debo was just smiling, laughing to himself. He said, oh, you want the bike? Dude, I didn't know. That's all I had to say, dude. The bike's right here. Walks with him for a couple of feet with that same smile on his face. Turns around. Gives that man the uppercut of his life. That was what I thought was going to happen between me and my dad during that whole exchange. I thought that I was going to wake up in intensive care at the hospital. I thought he was going to beat my ass. Like, he legitimately wanted to give me a high five. And I just stood there, wide-eyed, scared for my life. That's because my eyes. Okay. My mom and my dad are both T-Rexes, which makes me a strange adopted human black baby. But still enough, they won't kill me. And of course, I was God, bro. So fast forward, she gets the passport for all three of us. And my mom and dad, all of us, we get home. My mom has the nerve to turn to my aunt and say, oh, you have got me. Turns to my aunt who's outside on our porch. She turns to my aunt and says, your last name is caught watching porn, right? We start with all these exciting white, black, and Asian females I think it was one Latino. He just fought with all the types of deals on his phone. And my grandmother was outside listening to that whole conversation. And it doesn't help the fact that my mom came out there saying, "Hey, porn addict, maybe that your father wants you." I just didn't come out my room for the entire time that exchange was going on for. You would think that I am a Vietnamese soldier experiencing PTSD with how I flipped out. You would think that, hold on. Oof, it's calling. Oh, now they want to hang up. Okay. You would think I was like, no, I told you. It was probably how a dictator felt after the people started to, you know, uprise against him. That's why I felt like I was hot. My room was my bomb shelter. Or my fallout shelter. I was going to be waking up 20 years later. And I was going to be walking out my cryostasis time zone that they had in Fallout 4. I'll be waking up about that game. And I'll be like, oh, it's the 22nd century. Be waking up, got llama pumas and African rhinoceros. All those shits. Okay? I can't even say because it's crazy days. It's so hard for me to admit to people that I was caught at Walgreens on a big television with strangers walking back and forth with porn on my phone. You don't understand how hard it is for me to tell y'all this. But y'all my subscribers, y'all, I can't keep secrets from y'all. Nope. Exactly how it happened. Y'all, and my mom and dad haven't treated me the same since it happened. I don't even know if I should call this a story time, because this literally just happened yesterday. Maybe I'll edit it later, I swear it says story time. Maybe later on today. But you know, that's just it. Normally I would lie and say, I was like, "Daddy, what is wrong with you? Just give me a high five," or I would, you know, come out my room and say, "Mom, don't tell people my personal business." But you know, I can't talk back to my parents. That's because if you're black and you weren't raised in the suburbs, You understand why I couldn't do that. You understand what would have happened to me. I would have gone missing. Mate, I would have vanished off the face of the earth. The police would went out looking for me. And if they found me, they would find me at the cemetery nearby my house with my pants pulled down and red marks all over my ass. That's just exactly how it would go down. Verbatim. That's just what they would want right there. All the time that I had this thing. But you know, make sure to subscribe. And click that, well, it depends on, actually it's on every type of device. It's everywhere. If you look at every device, you look at the app. Subscribe, click that little bell up there, gives me notifications everywhere I'm posting on my channel. Make sure to like, comment, and the message at the bottom of the screen, please tell me if some shit like this ever happened to you. We got caught doing some shit that you didn't cope. I know that I shouldn't be laughing right now. And I'm not. And neither should any of you. None of you should be laughing at me. It's a serious, serious matter being caught with killing at home. Okay, you can laugh a little bit, but only when I say it's okay. Which is this entire video. You can laugh at the y'all. The question is, which that works. Which way do I go in order to? Okay. So what I'm basically getting is, no matter what, I'm on the right path. So this is why I should have stuck, you know, on my phone watching to my Samsung Galaxy S5. That's just, it had this new, just ingenious thing where it was called private mode, and you had to like enter a password into it in order to see, you know, all your old gallery posts. That was literally my best friend when I was like in middle school. So you know what? So the moral of this story is, buy Samsung price. You know, that's good. It will save you in the long run. Buy Samsung S5. Also, make sure your parents have their phone on you if they're going to be taking photos of you. And just not say that your phone's dead. Just flat out lie and say that your phone is dead. Doesn't matter. That's because when they go through your gallery, it's open. Of course, I didn't get any negative repercussions of this, except for the fact that I got laughed at by the chick who was literally like 200 pounds working the fucking wall. That was my punishment right there. And I deserve it. You shouldn't be watching this. You shouldn't be watching this. Actually, to be honest, it's kind of 50-50, you know, because porn can be addicting, but it can also be a lifestyle. Like one of those little dewy things. A floaty. It'll save you if you're drowning in something like a depression. If you're drowning in honestly, I don't know if you're drowning in that's where you need things, but you know, it can save you, that's all I'm trying to say. Bah, rebel. Jeez, my car is big. That person that looks like a lot more religious. Parking Master. Next guy to be in the Fast and Furious movies. Right here. You know, you can't see me. So black. Thank you all so much to take your time out for watching the famous YouTubers like, you know, Big Smosh, PewDiePie, the guy himself, Leafy is here, Corey X Kenshin, who has, Happy Wheel, take a picture of that, John. I'm catching up to that truck. Also, you guys are Corey Extension fans, and you don't know when he's going to come back, relax yourselves. Give me the Hot Wheels! I want a Hot Wheels fidget spinner! Give it to me! You can't escape! Give me my Hot Wheels fidget spinner! I want to end the broadcast, but not before I get my fidget spinner. Give it to me. I won't stop until I make this step. Pull over. Pull over. So I hope that you know that you broke the law by not giving me a fidget spinner. I hope that you understand that. And take a picture of this officer-like pullover for some Hot Wheels. Thank you all so much for watching. I will see all you guys later. What you want, mates? Boop!